But this is a story that I developed to teach about how Kamishibai is really about dialogue and sound effects and bringing the pictures to life, right? So this story actually has no words to it. I have the audience create the story with me. So what do you see happening in the picture? If you can give me some sound effects for what's happening. And then? That was pretty good. Should we try that again? All right, so let's have the crick cracks and then you do that. Crick, crack, 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 and... Oh, come on, that lacked. Yeah. And so this is a new dinosaur, so what is it going to do? Looks around and, oh, what's behind the card?
Mommy,
you think?
Or, oh no.
Oh no. Oh no. Okay, what sound would that make? Okay, and then what happens next? Okay, so usually at this point in the story, kids of all ages say, that was a terrible story! Why did you do that? And then why, what was so bad about it? I mean, that was a story, right? It was too short! We were just starting to like the little guy, and then he's gone. So I say, okay, okay, let's take that out and start over again. What's nice about this is if you do it, then they really notice that you need to make the story a little more involved than three cards to make it interesting. So now that they know that, you can start over again. Are you ready? Now we know what's coming up next. All right, so what's going to happen next this time? Right? If you have a character doing this, you can't go... Right? It's doing this. It's Oh, but now we have a new sound. What sound is that? Swap, swap, swap. It's probably flying and but the poor T-Rex, what's he doing? He's crying. Alright, but is this a good guy? We do not know. When suddenly what are they running into now? Help! He surprises the what is that, a pterodactyl? And oh no! Corrupts the scrupulomimus and what sound is this name? Oh, come on, we gotta do better than that.
Boing.
Boing! That's a good one. Okay, and this is a hard one. Oh, good. Okay. Now, in Japanese, there's a word for this. They actually say koro 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 koro. Can you all say that? Koro 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 koro.
What is it?
Boing. Okay. Koro 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 koro. Oh no, what's gonna happen next? Oh, come on, this is the climax. We can do better than that, right? Bang! There's stars. All right. And is this a good dinosaur, we ask?
Yes, it's not a carnivore.
And so, oops, skip the card. Takes him home. And that was just one day in the life. This, I think, is just a very brilliantly designed, simple story. It's called Meow, which is the sound that a kitten would make. So you can start out the story by just saying, this is Meow. She just opened her eyes. What do you think she's looking at? Any guesses?
Her mom.
But Meow has never seen the moon before. What do you think she thinks it might be?
A bowl of milk.
Her mother.
Well, could be, yeah. She stares. And stairs, but suddenly, what's happening? It's gone. Oh no! Now, Nyaon doesn't know what happened, but you do, right? I hope. Nyaon watches and waits and waits, and finally, clouds start to move again. And there it is. Well, this time she's not gonna let it get away, and so, yeah! It starts to chase after it. Yawn, you can do it, you can do it. She runs and runs and, but the moon seems to get further and further away. Yawn, she runs and runs until she's in the next game. What can she do? Ah, she has an idea. Pat, pat, pat. She's starting to climb up. She gets all the way to the top of the tree and, oh no, it's gone. Where'd it go? There it is. Uh-huh. And the moon says, good night.